have a pending tax appeal stacked ready to go.
Well, that's right, because, you know, the revenue's not coming, what's going to come in.
Well, that was one of the things we have to worry about. We don't really know exactly what all the appeals are going to be bringing to it. We're having to do basically a guesstimation of how that's going to work out, which we still feel comfortable with.
I got you. Yeah, I'll just give it, just give it.
It is, it was a concern, and it's part of the consideration. All right, is there anyone else that would like to speak in opposition to this, to the request of the increase? Please come forward. State your name and address for the record.
Laura Spell.
Right here.
Laura Spell, 5360 Golf Drive, Lake Park. What I'd like to know is, what do y'all think seniors are supposed to do? I mean, you're taxing us out of our homes. What do y'all want?
I hear what you're saying.
Anybody answer that? I mean.
We don't have an answer.
Seriously. Is anybody, you know, trying to fix that problem? I'm not saying we shouldn't pay nothing. I would rather we didn't pay anything. But it's just, it's going up year after year after year. What are we supposed to do? Can somebody take that into consideration?
We can start to talk about this now.
It's all I ask.
Thank you. Anyone else?
I agree.
Please come forward and state your name and address for the record, please.
My name's William Spell, Laura's husband, 5360 Golf Drive, Lake Park, Georgia. I go by Billy, but anyway, property taxes just increased about 20% from 2023 up to 2024 anyway. So like 14, I know Lambs County said on $200,000, $1,444 in 2023 is what your taxes was, $1,700 for 2024's taxes. I mean, that 20% increase already, and why do we need to increase more millage? I mean, to me, it's like giving you guys, my teenage kids, okay, they want a burger or fries back now, when you get them for $6, $7, I could give them $6, $7, well, I want ice cream too. I said, okay, well, I don't have anything but 20. Bring back change. Well, I don't get any change back. And the same thing about taxes. Every time it goes up, we don't see anything for it. The SPLOST tax, they are supposed to improve roads. The street in front of my house is terrible. I don't see any road improvement anywhere in the county. I travel around the county. But where does the money really go? I mean, I know you got this fancy screen up here and all this, but, you know, do numbers around, and I can do numbers around. But where does the money go? I don't see what I'm getting for my money. That's all I got to say about it.
Thank you.
I was born about the cost of it.
Yes.
Mr. Chairman, can we get Stephanie? Can you, do you have what it would cost, $200,000 in 2022 without the governor's reduction that year? Do you have those numbers available?
That's one thing that's made the whole thing a little bit.
I'd like to see where they were on the same $200,000 house in 2022 compared to where they are in 2024.
But also understand that.
Okay.
I apologize, but understand also, trying to minimize the dialogue. But one of the things as well is that there's a big difference between what your property is assessed at and what the millage is set at.
That's why I wanted to see what the taxes would have actually been on a house, a $200,000 house compared to the $1,700 we're looking at this year, compared to the $1,400 last year, because the big part of that gap is the governor's tax reduction that he gave. And so if it's comparable to the
same. Can I input something on that?
Yes, sir.
My statement was, sir, what a
fault.
Is it's already went up so much, 20% from 2023 to 2024, what's happening to my money?
Well, that's what I
want. Where's my money going? What are y'all doing with my money?
Can you give me just a second?
I think his question's a little bit different.
No, it's not. If we went back and showed him that the taxes in 2022 were somewhere around $1,700, there's not really that tax increase. What you're seeing, the difference between the 2023 and 2024 number, is the decrease in taxes that the governor gave us as an exemption. And it decreased your tax bill on a $200 house about $300. And so if you look at 2022 and compare it to 2024, you're not going to see a 20% increase. You're going to see it's going to be roughly about the same. But in 2023, had that reduction by the governor.
The revenues reduced off the taxes is increased every year.
No, sir. Hold on. Well, it may have increased, but it's not a 20% increase. If Stephanie can look that up for us.
I mean, I know, but the last 3 or 4 years, my income has not increased as much as whatever the percentage is you guys have. I'm 73 years old. I've been paying property taxes ever since I lived in the Lowndes County for 50 years.
Yes, sir.
When does it stop?
It doesn't. If you look at
I've been up taking my house because I get Social Security. My income's not that great. Okay, a lot of people out there get out of work and make more money. We have fixed incomes. We don't make more money. Every time y'all go up on our property, we've got to find money from somewhere else.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Thank you, sir. Appreciate it.
On the screen is last year's presentation for an unincorporated resident. That estimated tax bill was $1,400. The part, if you look at the Lowndes County portion, in 2022, that was $372. At the 7.356, which is the rollback millage, that's 1766, but the county portion is 391. So that went from 372 to 391.
So what kind of percentage increase is that?
That's
391 divided by 371?
391 versus 372.
372. So that's a 5% increase over a 2-year period. Basically. Okay.
And that's on the county portion.
Well, that's what I wanted to show, is that it didn't go up 20% on a $200,000 house. It's up 5% over 2 years.
So. All right. Is there anyone else who would like to speak in opposition? Come forward and state your name and address for the record. Following this one, we'll take one more and then we'll move to if there's anyone there who wants to support it.
Hello. My name is Kelly Wilson. It's 5392 Moss Oak Trail, Lake Park. I appreciate the roadmap. I want to say that first and foremost. But secondly, I'm a Lowndes County school teacher. My husband drives a school bus. We have to watch every penny we spend. When you say it's gone up a minuscule amount, however, property values have gone up. So our property, 1 year value, $40,000 higher, which means our taxes go up along with the percent increase. And so when I'm thinking about, hey, how can we save money? We got hit hard by the hurricane, as a lot of people did. But how can I save money? And I'm looking at, can I cut my phone bill from $100 to $60 just to save per month? And I'm out here teaching your kids, and my husband's driving a school bus. Taxes are not the go-to answer every time. Because if I'm having to make those decisions on where I can cut back, are you making those decisions on where you can cut back? And that's all I have to say.
Thank you, ma'am. All right. One more that would like to speak in opposition. Is there anyone else? Please come forward and state your name and address.
My name is Elaine Darity at 4731 McAllister Street. My house is only worth $100,000, but apparently the appraisers think it's worth a mint. Now, we've tried for years, we lived in this house and we're told it's worth nothing, it's worth $100,000, but in 4 years y'all increased it $42,000. I can't even park in my garage, it's so tiny. My driveway is tiny. The neighborhood looks disgusting because no one will keep their houses in good repair. The code enforcement, if you call them and tell them, oh, people are burning and it's not the burn weekends and it's just smoky out here and can y'all do something, call 911. Well, I don't understand. We're paying taxes. Shouldn't they come out? Shouldn't they come out and tell people your fence is halfway down? It's been that way for 5 years. Can't you clean the neighborhood up? The problem is, it's frustrating to everybody in here. Everybody. Everybody's in our pockets. And we're tired of it. And the lines on the road can be seen, just like his road. I don't see any improvements. In fact, we call it the redneck pothole. You hit it hard enough, you're going to ruin your vehicle. We can't see the lines at night. Nobody ever does anything. Bemis Road looks like junk. There's garbage down the road. There's grass growing in the gutters. So new families that move in to Moody Air Force Base get to see that lovely strip of land. And just it's just frustrating to, I'm sure, I'm the lowest income person here with the lowest house, and everybody's standing here saying, we want more money, and your house is valued at whatever astronomical figure you come up with, because I've done nothing but the house but try to maintain it, which we have swamp water to drink from. And I just don't think it's, I really don't think it's fair. And I think it's sad. I think it's sad for all of us. I work two jobs. I work 70 hours a week, 7 days a week. And it just kills me that I get another letter that the taxes are going up. And I almost feel like it's probably no point in even saying anything anymore, because you know people are pleading with us to come to these meetings, but it's like, what for? So that's all I have to say.
Thank you, ma'am. All right, is there anyone in the audience who would like to speak in favor of the increase? Anyone who would like to speak in favor? All right, hearing none, we'll close the public hearing portion of the meeting.